Well, going to show a little bit more progress of SCAMP number 179, Romana. We're going to start out here. Here is Romana's cruising power source, 50 watt photovoltaic panel. And that's why we're doing this in relatively dark conditions today. We want to start off with the lights off because I'm going to show you a little bit about the electrical system. All you see of it from here is a photovoltaic controller on the top and a switch panel underneath. The switch panel has two 12 volt outlets and the controller panel has two USB outlets. You might see the state of what's plugged in by the display. I'll come around that side. Show that things work. The top switch is for the navigation lights. You can see the port navigation light there. And the starboard navigation light peeping around the corner. Standard cruiser yacht nav lights have a light for the cuddy, provides plenty of light for working in the cuddy when you're at anchor, and too much light for cruising at night. One of the outlets is to be used to charge a VHF radio, which is now flat after 24 hours being on. We'll leave that on and it'll, in a couple of hours the battery will have replenished that. In the daylight it replenishes in about a half an hour. There's one spare switch setting. The photovoltaic power in is to come down through a slot in the mast blocks down into the storage area forward of bulkhead 3. So now all of the hatches have been installed permanently. They're all in and glued and there's rubbish everywhere, but try to ignore that. There's bits and pieces here. There's a cruising tent there that's going to be put together soon. I ended up with the simplest, the simplest possible way of filling the little triangular gap between the cabin side and the coaming. It's just a simple triangular piece of plywood which will be fiberglassed in and painted with the same deck paint. It's there. The other thing that has been completed, and I'll switch the light on now that we've seen everything else work, is to install the ports. So they're octagonal from the outside, octagonal pieces of octagonal constructions of hue and pine. And putting it in, I've made it that I need to do another couple of coats of varnish on the cabin sides. On the inside, it's held in place by the ring of an access hatch, so it sort of reflects the theme throughout the rest of the boat. There's lots of these access hatches and it's a very low profile, so that when I'm sitting in the cuddy there's not a lot of protrusion that's going to bang into my head. The The deck cleats, quite substantial, have now been permanently put in place on the decks. The next couple of jobs to be done before it moves out of the shed, to make room in here to finish off, some painting the inside of the mast trunk, putting in the doublers underneath the edge of the protrusions of the cuddy cabin, and finishing the varnishing and deck painting. There's going to be non-slip, a non-slip coating of the same deck paint over the areas where it'll be slippery when I walk. And at that stage, she'll come out of the shed, make way, and then we'll go back to the long list of things to be done. The centreboard and rudder are the two main things. The rig's quite a long way under construction at the moment. And some miscellaneous stuff, fittings, rollocks, a trailer, and that's pretty much it. Then she goes in the water. Can't really see an awful lot, but down here the rudder stock has been started, and the rudder itself has been started but not profiled. You can't see really, but underneath the centreboard case cover, the centreboard is hiding out of the way. That's 90% done. So although there's still a few things on the to-do list, quite a few of them have already been started. So we'll see how long it takes to finish off now. That's all from Lugs.